Welcome to this short video lecture on corrosion case study. We'll be talking about failure of stainless steel tubes used in alcohol vapor superheater. My name is Dr. K. Ile Perumal. I'm a corrosion and metallurgical consultant. Reasons for corrosion failure: deficiencies in design, material of construction, metal quality, process control, process impurities, process treatment. We'll see at the end this case study belongs to which of these reasons. The equipment concerned is a Schellen tube, a heat exchanger used for superheating alcohol vapor, which will be used to make some organic chemical product. The tube side is alcohol vapor. The alcohol vapor comes in around 140 degrees centigrade on the tube side. It gets heated up and then goes out at 183 degrees centigrade. This difference in temperature, about 40 degrees centigrade, is given by the shell side high pressure steam. The shell side high pressure steam, this is the inlet, and it gives away the heat and then goes out at a lower temperature. So this heat is utilized for evaporating the alcohol vapor and superheating it to this temperature. The tubes are made out of type 304 stainless steel, and the size is very popular size 19 mm OD by 2.77 mm wall thickness. The problem which we are going to discuss is a leakage in the tubes within 7 months of operation. 7 months is a very low period of concern. That is why the detailed study was conducted. This is the transverse cross section showing the leaked tubes. You can see approximately about 30% of the tubes leaked. This shows schematically the longitudinal section showing the leaking crack position. You can notice this is the bottom tube sheet and these are the tubes. The cracks occurred just about 5 mm, just above the top surface of the bottom tube sheet. There is a similar tube sheet on the top also. So this indicates there is some problem in this area. These are the typical metallographic structures in the as polished condition. It shows localized pits on the alcohol surface. This is the inside surface where alcohol flows. And this, you can see localized pitting corrosion, and also you can see multiple cracks initiating on the alcohol internal surface at several places. The propagation, or the previous slide shows initiation and this slide shows propagation. The propagation is transgranular branching cracks, and it initiated in two or three places, and that is why it is called multiple cracks. Multiple transgranular branching crack means it is a stress corrosion cracking. So the diagnosis, chloride stress corrosion cracking. This feature indicates it is a chloride. We will slowly see where is the chloride coming from. Condition for stress corrosion cracking: 4 parameters have to be satisfied. One is material, material of construction of the component, temperature of operation, there must be some corrosive agent, and there must be some tensile stress. That is why the word is called stress corrosion cracking. First of all, the material. In this case, the material, as we mentioned earlier, it is a 304 stainless steel. This data is a very prominent, well-used data. It shows weight percent nickel and time of failure for each value of nickel. And this lowest point corresponds to maximum susceptibility to stress corrosion cracking. That means minimum time to failure. And it so happens the popular stainless steel 304 SS belongs to the lowest point, approximately about 8 to 10% nickel. And so this shows that that material, namely 304SS, is susceptible to this chloride cracking. The next parameter is temperature. Here, what you see here in a summary of industrial experience, temperature versus chloride concentration for chloride stress corrosion cracking to occur based on industrial experience. These dark points show that stress corrosion cracking has occurred under that particular chloride concentration and that particular temperature. There is a well accepted minimum temperature of about 55 degrees below which stress corrosion cracking does not take place. You can see, except very low concentration at very high temperature, most of these lie above 55 degrees centigrade. In the present case, our operating temperature of about 170 degrees centigrade is very well above 55 degrees centigrade. So temperature condition is all satisfied. And this is a corrosive agent. Alcohol is by themselves is not corrosive. That is why stainless steel has been used, and alcohol purity is supposed to be maintained for further treatment of alcohol for some organic product. Here is surprising results. The purity as per specification of the alcohol is 91.96, but the actual used is 91.3. That may not look very difference, but that is important for further handling. That is why they are very specific about the purity. And the moisture, only the trace is allowed, whereas 7.64% moisture was found in the particular batch of alcohol being used. So the next is important corrosive agent is chloride. This chloride is, the chloride is dissolved in moisture and leads to this corrosion problem. And you can see the starting, the alcohol is a bought out item. It's a raw material, but bought from some other source. So as received alcohol from tank, it already shows an acidic pH of 4.8 with the chloride content of about 43 ppm. This is a substantial amount of chloride, as we have seen in the previous slide. And when the problem occurred, the downstream condensate, that means the alcohol coming at the top of the superheater and collected somewhere, and that itself shows 9 ppm chloride at a very highly acidic pH of 3.5. This shows that alcohol carries a corrosive impurity, namely chloride. Then the last point is stress. Since the word is called stress corrosion cracking, there must be a tensile stress. So here is a point of tensile stress. All the cracking occurred just about 5 mm above the tube sheet. When heat exchangers are fabricated, the tubes are expanded into the tube sheet hole so that it remains tight, and then there is no crevice left. So this expansion sometimes goes beyond the length of the tube sheet. So that is why this is just below this only the cracks have occurred. Above this, there is no stress. So this is the point of stress. So all the four conditions are satisfied. Conditions for stress corrosion cracking satisfied. This is the type 304 stainless steel, highly susceptible to stress corrosion cracking. The temperature is very well above 55 degrees centigrade, and corrosive agent chloride is present in the medium, and there is a residual tensile stress due to tube expansion. So all these conditions satisfy the diagnosis chloride stress corrosion cracking. The recommendation based on this diagnosis is avoid liquid carryover to the evaporator. This is a superheater. That means it is supposed to be superheat the alcohol vapor. There should not be any liquid, and particularly liquid with water and chloride should be avoided. The other alternative is change the source of alcohol, one free from chloride. Since alcohol is a bought out item, they should change the supplier who will give them alcohol free of water and free of chloride. The last alternative is, if these two are not possible, change the material of construction from, that is MOC, from the 304 stainless steel to duplex stainless steel, which is known to have very high resistance to all form of stress corrosion cracking, particularly chloride stress corrosion cracking. Here is a comparison of stress level required to induce cracking for different materials, starting from austenitic stainless steel. 304 and 316 are practically same for this purpose. Next is duplex, which we mentioned in the previous slide. Then this is a super duplex, and these are all very high nickel austenitic stainless steel. What is given in the y-axis is a percentage of the yield strength at the operating temperature about 200 degrees centigrade. You can notice just about 2 or 3% of the yield strength, 304 and 316 will crack, whereas for duplex, you require at least about 35-40% of the yield strength. That means the duplex will withstand higher stress during this process. All other materials will be more expensive. So that is the reason why 2205 duplex has been recommended. This point has been illustrated here. What you see here, stress corrosion cracking failure as a function of applied stress level. You can see both 304 and 316 do start cracking at very low applied stress, whereas duplex, this is a duplex stainless steel which has been recommended, and this duplex stainless steel will crack only if the applied stress is around 60 to 80% of the yield strength. And this is the reason why duplex stainless steel has been recommended for this particular case study. So the key takeaway on this case study is, we have seen the premature failure of stainless steel tubes used in alcohol vapor superheater. So this category is of failure belongs to the reason of impurity in the process medium. So stress corrosion cracking due to process impurity. Thank you very much. You see the book written by me and Professor V.S. Raja of IIT Mumbai. This book will give you details of corrosion theory and several failures. Thank you again.